Let's see if this will let me play it. I saved off my last recording, but I never finished. I never saved it. Nice luck swimming this. Don't think. Did you call it goat farm? That's Zoria, Merritt, Dear Future Friend, Once Upon a Time in Ireland, while the Zoria glittered like a multicolored gem in the ocean. This land was home to many friendly and hardworking souls, but life had become difficult for them. Magical hardships had deprived them of their coziness and separated them from their friends and even their homes. But I, Mayor Merritt, know that someone like you can help us. Someone who wants to farm, explore, and have an adventure or two. Lately, even reaching our island required a treacherous journey throughout turbulent seas, but a brave adventurer can overcome any dangers. Will you join us, Zoria? The better for having. Use your map to find your house and check out your welcome package. Okay. I can do that. The message in the bottle was true, a lonely farm is waiting for you here, all you had to do is claim it. You don't let me close. I'm gonna sleep out of bound. There's something right there. I don't know if I hit it, but it's something right there. been over this way. I'll look when I get a chance. And you can get it on Steam. And I think you can get it on the Switch too. So, Jersey, if you want to look into that. Yo, was it Harry? You got a backpack inventory. You can press I to open your backpack and view or use items you collect along your journey. Thanks again for coming to Azoria. I hope you stay a long time. So what do you think of your new home? Welcome kit was pretty sweet, right? Rhythm. Backpack. I know you love it. Azoria is the perfect place to live, assuming you're okay with magical thorns and suspicious weather patterns. Why don't you try to give your home its own name? Give it that special Shiloh's 89 touch. I forgot what I called the home. Or did I not name it? Did I name it? I don't remember. Anyway, guys, what do you want to name it? Because if anything, I'm just going to call it Shay's house, so. Oh, well. Not gonna let me delete. I mean, I didn't name it, but whatever. Don't tell me what you named it. Speaking of this one. house. This house comes with one right here. This is the farm. I was trying to delete it to fix the name, but whatever. Yes, okay, it seems better day and will require some elbow grease, but you survived the whirlpool, so it's nothing you can't handle. Besides, it shouldn't take too long to tidy up the place, not with your own set of random tools. Did I get tools? Give me tools? Okay, I just got tools. You got a set of starter tools, use your tools. It's easy. Go up to the object and press the whatever clicker. The right tool for the job will be used automatically. Okay. Just make sure to keep an eye on your energy. With those beginner tools, you can get all kinds of things done. And you can upgrade them later at Cinder Smithies by the docks to tackle tougher jobs. Try clearing away rocks, logs, wild grass, harvesting wild greens. On the land around your home, you can keep all the materials you can gather. Basically the same thing I did, Talia. I'm like, why is it taking so long? It's true that the land around your farm has been neglected. How about tidying that up? You're likely to find some useful resources at the same time. So, I'm not supposed to do it around the house or down here. Ooh, a butterfly. Can I turn on these small trees? No. Second to the tree. What is the Wild Spring? What's the Wild Spring Green? I know what I'm looking at. Oh, these. Okay. This is just giving me Animal Crossing a little bit. There. What is the better for having you? Okay, how many times did I repeat that? Nice job. Now that you've got some space cleared, how about I show you how to use it? Sure. In order to make something, you'll need to construct it yourself, but it is easy as falling down. See, you can build all kinds of things indoors and outdoors. Just gather the raw materials and then start construction. If you don't know what materials you need, just check your almanac. Craft and place the round stone inside. Send me to my home, but then you send me all the way back this way. So now I gotta run back. Okay. go over here. There we go. This is cute. Oh, this is cute. This is cute. Bessie, would this be something you would play? This one I know is on the Switch already. The other one, I don't know when they're going to put that one on the Switch. Honestly speaking, you can build decorative things inside out or outside. How you set up your farm is up to you. Uh-huh. And we already built your mailbox. Miles, the postman will deliver your letters and packages first thing in the morning, so don't forget to check your mail. Well, now what you should build next, a cooking fire. Have a cooking fire on your farm is the easiest way to cook up a hot meal. You can always make fancier equipment later. These are all the kinds of things you can on your cooking fire. I've seen wild greens around. There's mussels on the beach, so I've seen those. I don't want to put it directly in front of the steps. Thank you. took something using, like, something very uncollected. Let's see what you cooked. Bravo, you see, with a cooking fire you can roast and toast your heart's content. Home cooked food always tastes better, I say. Cooked food gives you more energy than raw and sells for more money at the market too. By using different raw ingredients to see how they can be transformed into tasty treats. Experiment. You know, get jazzy with it. I know what you're thinking, Shay. When it's Merritt's going to teach me about farming. Right now, let's get our hands ready and play with some seeds and soil beds. You know, I'm pretty sure I left some seeds and construction material in the store. Oh, that's my storage shed? Okay. You have a storage shed, by the way. Go get the materials in your storage shed, then construct some soil beds on your farm and plant one seed in each. Turnip seeds. Craft and basic soil. Okay. Craft and place basic soil bed. And place and press. Wonderful job, Hello. Soon your fields will be sprouting with ground grown goodness. Say that 5 times fast. Say that 3 times fast. I'm not attempting to do that at all. Just don't forget to water your seeds. They won't grow unless they're watered. Though if it rains, you can skip a day. I hope you keep tending to your fields. As farmers always say, don't leave them alone. Ha ha, you have fun. You've done so much to improve your farm already. I bet you aren't even thinking about that harrowing journey across the ocean. Oh, you should meet your neighbors. Word has probably already spread that you're here. We're a bit of a small town, you see. You should go to talk to Eddie the Mariner. He's probably near his home in the Stay a Wild Bay. He'll have a fishtail or two share. Nope. Say no more. Get out the water. Oh, the area I was already at. Items of this imports with her shipping warehouse. Hello. you're enthusiastic. The weather's getting warmer. It will be summer soon than we think. Sooner than we think. What I can't read. Yeah. It feels so good when the weather gets warmer. Okay. A bunch of seashells. Ooh. Dang, get out the water. Out. Out of the water. Out of the water. Hello, landlubber. Have you been exploring it? Have you been exploring it? Alan's got a lot of secrets ready for the finding. Good to see you, Shelos. No one's told you I'm Eddie Azaria's old mariner. Mariner, actually. I'm just saying it. I hear you've gotten a little farm going. I won't hold that against you, even though fishers and farmers have been at odds forever. Never mind that. You haven't lived until you fish. Believe me, give me the seas over the trees any day. How about old Eddie gives you a quick lesson in the art of the rod and reel? Hot dog, I'm ready whenever you are. Alright, go out there and catch a fish, any kind. Like salt or fresh water. I'll even give you my old rod. May it serve you well. Now, hold out your rod and cast it so the bobber lands near the mouth of the fish. Then reel it in a bit at a time, not too fast. Hypnotic motion should encourage the fish to strike. When the fish has bitten, you get to reeling fast. All at once, though, your line turns red, it's ready to break. Just stop for a moment until it turns white again. Keep it up, and with a little luck, you'll reel in a prize. Go fishing and tell me about it. Okay. Don't you let me go fishing? Can I get off this? Oh wait, I can window the. That's that helps. So where should I go? Yes, this way. Ding on fish. Gotcha. Welcome back. No. What this man? Ahoy. There's a lot to do on the island, Landlubber. Talk to people, learn what you can. Oh, what's going on? Ah, you seem to have done well for yourself. Tell me how the fishing is. Well done, my friend. You're on your way to becoming a marine master. Maybe you'll even learn the farm for the seas one day, like I did. Enough of that. I've taught you all. I can. I've seen you grow from a minnow to a sardine. I think it's time that you spoke with our local beekeeper. Now I gotta mess with bees. Teach about the critter catching, and you are going to want to pay attention to that. Ultimel the beekeeper. Okay. I'll do that in a minute, but can I look at these? Can I sell these? Because if I can sell these, I'll do it.
Thank you.
Let me go to the map. Figure out what this person is. It wouldn't let go of the thing. Leave me alone. Hi. Good for you on coming to Azoria. It must have been quite a journey. Yeah. A new face. When I heard someone washed up on the shore, I could hardly believe it. Oh, these puns. Shayla's 89. Eh? It's nice to meet you. You must have a lucky clover in your boot to have made it past the whirlpool. No. I'm Mel. I hope everyone is treating you well. It's been so long since we had someone new on the island. Bees have been all abuzz about it. Oh my god. You moved into the abandoned farm. Wonderful. Hey, since you're new here, let me show you how we catch bees and other critters here on Azoria. Azoria is a haven for critters, mostly because they outnumber us Azorians by a wide margin. Now, don't worry about how these critters feel about it. Develop the most gentle, cozy critter net. It's like, hey, this is definitely giving me Animal Crossing. Equip your net and swing it to catch a critter to improve your chances. Ready your net and approach the critter slowly. Why don't you take a couple of swings to catch a few critters and come back and show me. I just know you're going to catch a critter catching bug. What's this? Oh, it's energy. What are you? Ooh, a big old slug. Well, it's a snail because it has a shell, but so. No. It's for you on coming to us. Blah, 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 blah. Well, how did that feel? Nice, right? Ooh. Ooh. I need to get back to the game. That's why I clicked me out onto the, Twitch. You can keep that net. We got great technique. I can see you becoming an average critic. Remember, the critics can leave you little gifts if you add them to a conservatory. Lord, I cannot read. But that's for later. The mayor said not to overwhelm you. You know, there are many critic collectors on this island. If you catch a critic, you can always sell it. There's always someone in Azoria who would like to buy. You can sell just about anything, really, and then you'll earn florins. That's the local currency, if no one told you. Well, selling things is really Pearl's specialty. She's the chairwoman of the Merchants Guild. It's kind of a big deal around here. I'm sure she would love to tell you all about selling things. You can find her in the town center marketplace. It's been a real pleasure chatting with you. Center, and I'm gonna meet up with Pearl. You know, I saw Pearl before I went to him. Oh, she left from here. Okay. Hi. Spring forage is the tastiest. I will look forward to picking huckleberries all winter. Hello, fellow entrepreneur. You must be Shiloh's 89. Fantastic to meet you. I am Pearl, the head of the Merchants Guild. You know, I bet you have a bunch of stuff in your pocket that you'd like to get rid of. Am I right? What if I told you you could turn that random junk into gold hard food? True, you can sell that stuff for florins right here and now. On the market, and then the money is in deposit automatically. Now's that not the time for questions. It's time to learn and pay attention, because what I'm about to say can change your life. Everything in Azoria sells, even plant fibers. Sold. Spring peeper. That's a spring peeper. Sold. And it's so easy. Jiku? Is that it? Okay, could do it. See in the middle of the market tables, put something on those tables and by the next morning it's sold. Is anything on the market table or produce stand in this? Make sure there's at least three. These tables here. Now, where's Mary? Oh, I'm about to say. You're back, Shiloh. I've been hearing such wonderful things about you. Sounds like you've been becoming a real Azorian and aren't furious about getting shipwrecked here. Yay. All's well that ends well. You can get a house. You get a house and a farm, and we get a first new resident in, well, I can't remember. I don't actually remember when the whirlpools appeared, but things weren't going great even before that. But nothing you can't handle. Now that you've got your tools, rod, and net, you can handle anything. So many questions. There will be plenty of time for answers, but you must be so tired of talking. How about we put a pin in this and you head on home? Great. And I think you're going to do great things for Azorius. I got some type of achievement that popped up, but I didn't see it. No, since we did this, did wake up. What else can I... A beverage station? That is. A wizard map, but I need something else. And I need something else for that. Oh, I need clay. Okay. Nope, I don't have it. Botanical magical menace. New day brings new letters to the mailbox. I can sell these or I can cook them. Oh, can I now sign up for multiplayer? Because I tried to do it and it did not want me to. I couldn't get to it. So, hopefully, you can get this game and join me. And on, I think once Palia opens and Twitch and all that stuff, you should be able to join me in that too. My fellow Faith Farmer, did you know your friends can join you in the wonderful world you've created? Now I know. Thank you. All you have to do is press escape to open the main menu and select multiplayer begin. You can then invite your friends to your online game. Or if you would rather host a local game, ask each of your friends to go to their title screen and join the world screen to enjoy playing together the Faith Farm. Scattered scrolls. I think I've been picking them up. Yeah, to get recipes and all this stuff. All Azorians, the recent magical windstorm that sent debris flying had a most peculiar effect on our shop. In brief, the wind scattered many of our recipe scrolls in all directions. However, we do not wish for them to be returned. Instead, consider these our contribution to the beautification of Azoria. Follow these recipes and create wonderful things. For example, one special scroll contains the recipe for a customization mirror. This magical invention permits you to change your hair, body shape and face. You can transfer your appearance at will this and other marvelous creations await those who find and follow our recipes. Okay. So you might have noticed some unusual magical things happening around Azoria. It isn't too serious, except it kind of is. You come over and talk. He is a large wizard. I didn't see this one. Oh, I'm gonna get a mirror. Fish. Looks like it's full. I'm gonna end up selling some stuff for her. Dang it! Why am I always falling in the water? Get out the water! Yeah. Well, it's got a lot of wild magic. It's my job as a wizard to bring some order to it. Okay. Kind of like Harry Potter, but alright. Salutations, Sheila. My name is Alaric, your humbled wizard of Azoria. The mayor let us all pick our titles. She vetoed Mel's first title, which was Azoria's Honey Bear. Yes, of course, you're wondering why I mailed you, of course. Okay, so, Azoria has a lot of magic. Wild magic, to be specific, as in uncontrolled, possibly dangerous magic. Oh, no, I don't mean to worry you. No, wait, I do, because it's pretty dangerous. You fear nothing. Well, that's good to hear, but probably doesn't lend a good decision making. I know what I must do. I will build you a magical staff. You can use it for protection and to harness some of your wild magic. That was my tummy. I've been so worked up that I forgot to eat. I had a warm meal in days. Do you think you can make me some home-cooked food? I've been eating raw mussels, and I think I'm about to turn into one. I saw it ill. Pick a muscle from each store, bright muscle. I already have that, but I guess they want me to pick up one. If my person stay falling up, stay going into the water, like. So now I gotta go to the beach and get you a muscle. But don't you fall into that water. Okay, so I'm gonna have to jump over. Woman! Just jump, thank you. Okay, anyways. Oh, okay. I was like, I cannot even see what you're saying over there. I already picked up a muscle, but if you drop the muscle, I can do that. Give me a crib. You miss Stardew, don't you? Mark and I met where the thorns were the thickest. He presented me with the oddest magical staff I've ever witnessed. But looks can be deceiving. But the thorns began receding. And Jumble should be afraid of my new power. Good natured Azorians need no longer cower. So, I'm going to end my stream here. I don't know if I want to find somebody else that's playing the game. But I will be getting on the other one. just to catch up on that one. And I will be editing a video for Palia, how it's pronounced. I will be editing a video for that. I need to put up my other reactions. So, look out for that. I don't know who to give this. Have you seen Mario Bros. Wonder yet? I will see you guys next Saturday because I'm off that day. Now will be another time I stream either this or finish off baseball. See you guys later.